I select a number of entries for which I want to upload the whole genome MLST analysis to the calculation engine. And I press the first button to submit the jobs. The dialog popping up allows me to choose the calculations I want to have performed on these entries. Two procedures are in place for the allele identification. Either the assembly-based methodology identifies the alleles from the de novo assembled genomes using BLAST, or the assembly-free method, which is computationally less intensive but thorough. For each job, I can adjust the settings if I want. Jobs that have already been submitted and have been imported successfully will not be relaunched for analysis, unless the checkbox in front of the resubmit already processed data is checked. An overview window will open, listing all jobs and their progress. Details on users, submission time, job status and progress are shown. This list can be updated manually, pressing this button. You can also have this window updated automatically. If you go to File, Settings, here for instance, the window will be updated automatically every 10 minutes. Double-clicking on a job displays the job log information. By activating the drop-down box, one can filter the jobs and choose to display only jobs that have been submitted or that are queued, running, finished or failed. A selected job can be cancelled with this button. Or a job can be fully deleted with the cleanup button. To import calculated results from the calculation engine into BioNumerics, we choose Jobs, Get Results. Once the results are imported, the corresponding jobs and their underlying datasets are automatically deleted from the calculation engine. Only the whole genome MLST allelic profiles are stored in the BioNumerics database as character sets, keeping your database fast and responsive.